The oasis of Fayoum to the south of Cairo. In the pharaonic era, this was wetlands, a place for hunting and fishing. During the Middle Kingdom, about 1800 before Christ, huge works were undertaken that turned this region into one of the most fertile of all Egypt. Still today, this rich agricultural land produces an abundance of all sorts of fruits, vegetables, and grain. The Fayoum was the breadbasket of Egypt for the Romans. They exported wheat from here throughout the empire. However, it only rains a few days each year, and yet water is needed and must be carefully distributed. Until recent times, the Nile flood provided much water loaded with precious silt. But the dams and the river have controlled the water supply, and the peasant farmers have had to come up with other solutions. Canals built in the pharaonic era channeled the waters of the Nile towards the oasis. Ingenious machines were used to raise the water so that it might irrigate even the smallest field. But most of these machines, like the Sakieh, have now disappeared from the Egyptian countryside, as its owner explains.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. اسمي السيد علي سليمان مزارع بالقرية هي معمولة من حوالي 50 سنة وكانت بتخدم الأرض العالية الأرض مرتفعة عن مستوى المية مترين فالصنعة السائلية علشان تروي المساحة دي اللي عملها نجار السوائي أيوة هو أبوه كان نجار سوائي وجده كان نجار سوائي وهو طلع بعد يوم نجار سوائي
يعني مصدر المية اللي بتجيبها الساقية بحر يوسف
وبعدين تنزل في بحر صنهور اللي هو عليه سوق الهديه ترفع 6 متر تيجي في الأنية دي تخش على الساقية دي اسمها ساقية مواشي سقيت مواشي انما دوكا سقيت اصغر اصغر من دوك اصغر من الهديه السلام ورحمه الله وبركاته
وبعدين بتسقي 15
وبعدين تسقي 15 في الدنيا لان هي العزبه مساحتها 50 في الدنيا
العزبه اللي احنا موجودين فيها
بيسقيها سواق الهدير بتسقي 50 في الدنيا
طب العزبه اللي احنا فيها دي اسمها ايه؟
عزبه الجبل لان سميت عزبه الجبل لان المنطقه دي منطقه جبليه كانت جبل عالي اعلى وكانت رمله وبتاع فلما زرعناها وجدنا ان فيها صعوبه في الساقيه بنرفع ميه من مترين بعد 6 متر فقلنا نشيل المساحه دي ونخليها كلها تشرب على مستوى سواق الهدير
يبقى احنا مش محتاجين كده
يبقى احنا مش محتاجين دي يعني دي واقفه بقالها حوالي من 5-6 سنين ما بتشتغلش
كانت بتروي ال 15 فدان دول باجر مدفوع ولا لا
لا كل واحد يجيب البقرة بتاعته ويعلقها في الساقية ويروي.
The remains of Sakieh have been found on many archaeological sites. This one, to the southwest of Alexandria, was used to irrigate vineyards on a Roman farm. This fresco in the Greco-Roman Museum of Alexandria is one of the oldest images of a Sakieh. The device was powered by oxen, just as can be seen on this sketch from the beginning of the 19th century, drawn by Vivant Denon, the illustrator who accompanied Napoleon Bonaparte's expedition to Egypt. Until the end of the last century, it was the principal means of irrigation used by the Egyptian peasant. Sakieh were also used in towns to supply drinking water to wealthy homes from cisterns and wells dug beneath the houses. The Sakieh at Fayoum is one of the last such wooden machines still in place. It is one of a kind known as a zawafa. It is different from the traditional Sakieh in that it has two wheels instead of three, and the water is lifted from a canal and not a well, How does it work?
هو ده اسمه الترس الصغير بيبقى عليه اواديس خشب برضه مبطنه بالصاج تنزل تجيب المايه من تحت وتطلع من الناحيه الثانيه تكب في المجرى دي تكب على الخشب ده والخشب ينزل على القنايه الصغيره دي توصل الارض ده اسمه الترس الكبير ده ما هو ده اسمه الترس تروس زي يعني مصنوع من خشب وده ترس علشان وهنا برضه بيبقى فيه تروس على اساس ان الترس ده بيركب مع ده كده عشان يدور ده يلف وده يلف معاه الجزء ده زي ماسك في الساقيه
اسمه ايه؟
دي اسمها الهديه
الهديه
بيتربط فيها حبل والمكان ده بيتحط فيه ضمط خشبه برضه كده طويله زي دي تتحط على رابط البهيم والحبل ده يوصل يتربط ده في ده
فالبهيمه
بتزيح على كتفها بقى بتزيح تفضل ماشيه كده ودي تلف معاها تلف تطلع الميه وتروي الارض
طيب والنخله
اسمها الجازيه
دي بقى
واقفه فوق على عمود هنا وعمود هنا من الطوب على اساس انها سنده دي من فوق يلف في الفتحه دي عشان ما يتحركش لا كده ولا كده زي ما سيادتك شايف كده الارض نزل مستواها المترين يعني احنا شلنا المترين دي في المسطح ده ونقلناها في ارض واطيه ونزلنا المترين دول والارض الزرعه زي ما انت شايف كده شجر مانجا وبرسيم وكسو يعني زرعت كل الارض
There have been other machines for lifting water. A rather crude system was the mintal. A simple container allowed water to be raised to a low height. The first true lifting tool was the shadouf, which is represented in the tomb of Ipu from the 19th dynasty at Deir al-Medina. A few of them can still be seen in the Egyptian countryside. Does this farmer know that people were already using the same machine more than 3,000 years ago? The Archimedes screw. This system for lifting water is said to have been invented by Archimedes and is much more efficient than the shadouf. It has completely disappeared from the Egyptian landscape today. Some decades ago, wooden sakieh gave way to sakieh made of metal. Today, a few are still to be seen, eaten by rust. They were powered in the same way as the wooden versions by a beast of burden, buffalo, cow or ox, donkey or camel. Not long ago, engine-driven galvanized iron sakieh appeared on the scene. They can lift much, much more water. In the Fayoum, there are still a few water wheels, or noria, as they are called in Egypt. These great engines lift the water using the force of the current. But for how much longer? The norias one could see just a few years ago have already disappeared. They've been replaced by motor pumps, the most common means of irrigation today. The big day has arrived. The peasants of the neighboring village have come to lend a helping hand to dismantle the sakieh, and the talk is of evenings past.
كان بيجي الراجل يقعد هنا اللي هو يركب عليها هنا كده وهي دايره وقاعد بقى يغني بقى ومبسوط يعني بيرو ارض فيقول لها يا ساقيه دوري دوري وملي لي المجرى ميه ايوه كانوا بييجوا يعني بالليل الواحد يسقي بالليل كلنا نيجي نقعد معاه ونشوي ذرة نعمل شاي نعمل كده بعدين سهرة مع بعض
The Sakieh is on its way to France, firstly by road, along the Nile Valley and through the Delta until Alexandria, where the container is loaded onto a ship. After a few days at sea, the pieces of the Sakieh are unloaded at Fos-sur-Mer to be restored in the workshop of Patrick Dvorak.
On va tâcher de redresser le début de la roue qui est un petit peu tordue. On a cette partie ici qui est très abîmée. Pour les parties collage, on tâchera de faire des collages qui ne se voient pas trop et on remaquillera bien évidemment avec le même type de goudron qui a été coulé dessus. Et ensuite, on rebâtira tout ça et ce sera transportable, je pense.
The Sakieh is now exhibited in Marseille, in the Museum of the Civilizations of Europe and the Mediterranean.